things are hard in your eyes. You forget the sun in his jealous sky as we walk in fields of gold.
Hello? Hi, honey. Can you hold on a second? It is pouring out there. What's that?
Listen, I'm not going to get home for another hour, hour and a half, so...
Oh, it's okay.
I got about a billion pages to read.
Yeah. I know all this late stuff has nothing to do with the promotion. You're just having an affair with your secretary.
Actually, it's, Epperson's secretary.
What about dinner? You want me to nuke some chicken?
No, how about Italian? Petronis?
Oh, you think you'll get through with work in time? They close at 11.
Yeah, I'll make it home in time.
What is your definition of motherly?
Oh, a nesting instinct.
Huge desire to hug everyone at all times. So.
Mitch, I'll never feel like cleaning. Okay. Bye, sweetie. I love you.
I love you, too. I'll see you soon, okay?
Bye.
Thank you. Somebody broke into your house.
What, oh my God, are you okay?
Easy, easy.
It's okay. It's okay.
Head trauma here.
What happened to her? Is she gonna be all right?
It's okay, baby. It's all right.
Well, someone tell me what happened.
Leslie, right here, take over.
Right here. I'm right here, baby. I'm right here.
We're gonna take her to county hospital, so you can ride with her in the back if you
yeah,
like.
All right, all right.
Mitch.
Here I am, Dawn.
Victim of a sexual assault, head injury with subsequent vomiting, possible rib fracture, difficulty breathing, vaginal bleeding, vitals normal.
CAT scan, head stat, chest x-ray with rib details set up for pelvic with a rape kit. She taking any medication?
Clomid.
Fertility drugs, how long?
18 months.
All right, do CBC, liver function, HIV, administer Ativan 1 milligram. We'll take it from here, sir. Mr. Hayward?
Yes, doctor. How is she?
Well, as you know, she's been sexually assaulted. She suffered other injuries as well. She has a moderate concussion, which we don't expect to cause any additional complications. All her blood tests were negative. She has a fractured rib, L7, right here. And no question, it's going to hurt for a while.
Doctor, is she going to be okay?
The pressure from the rib displacement caused a laceration on her left kidney. Now, in all likelihood, she's going to be okay.
Good.
I'm going to need you to convince your wife that she's going to be with us for a couple of weeks. And you can go see her. She's sedated. She'll be very groggy. If you're doing all right.
Thank you for your help.
Sorry.
Third door.
Third door on the right.
Maybe nobody was stupid.
I was going to
nobody
the house
was stupid.
The phone was ringing. I thought it was you.
I
left the keys in the door. My husband left the keys in the door. I had just been more careful.
Ellen, if I wouldn't have called you, if it hadn't been raining.
Shh.
It's nobody's fault. Shh. It's nobody's fault.
Okay.
Okay.
I have to go to sleep now.
Yes, you go to sleep.
Will you stay?
Of course I'll stay. Ellen, it's over. It's all over.
Son, I'm playing on the wheelchair.
Get over here right now! Where is Spirit?
He wasn't riding the horse.
You left him alone? I thought I asked you to take care of him. Sometimes. Shame on you. The wheelchair is not a toy. Thank you. Oh my goodness. Jared!
Cowboy,
what are you doing here? Just get away from him.
Hey, what are you doing here? Get him off.
I don't need your help.
Thank you. Just let him finish.
From us. Come on.
Hey, is it my fault I happen to be here when you're here? It was an accident. What am I supposed to do? Ignore my own kids?
Oh, what else have you done? Accident. You followed us here.
Hey, why can't you let me see my own kids?
Get away from us or I'm calling the police. You are not supposed to be within 1,000 feet of us.
Matthew, go to see your daddy.
Get him out of this. Just get away, Lois. Stop terrorizing us.
Terrorizing? You're destroying this family, Donna. Those are my kids, too.
Hang on.
What are you looking at?
Dr. Janet Cottrell, emergency admitting.
I think that looks like him. I can't be sure.
only saw part of his face.
You want to try again? Maybe a different chin.
I think that's the best I can do. He kept pushing my face away. It was dark.
Okay. Dark. All right, that's all right. This is good. You did good.
Thank you, Mrs. Hayward.
Okay.
If you think of anything else at all about this guy, a distinguishing feature or something he said.
I told you, he said he'd kill me if I went to the police. He said he'd kill me in
my
head.
Honey, it's okay. It's okay.
I know he threatened you, Mrs. Hayward. But if it's any comfort at all, that's the first thing most of these guys say.
No one's gonna hurt you. No one's gonna hurt me. All right?
Okay.
You let me know the minute you nail this son of a bitch, okay, Detective?
We'll be in touch with you soon. Thank you, Miss Hayward.
Oh, Mitch. You look so tired.
I'm fine.
You've got to get some rest before you go to work.
Ellen, I'm not going into the office today. I'm staying right here with you.
You have to go to work. It's important.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm. Go. Go.
Okay. Dr. Sam Flanagan,
Dr. Pope, please
call the cabinet. Ellen? What do you want me to say? I haven't even thought about that.
You don't have to protect me. Just tell them what happened.
It's all right. It's all right. I'll worry about that. No, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have even brought it up. I'll think of something, okay? All right. I'll call you soon.
Good morning, Mitch. Here are your messages.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you for holding me. I help you?
So what are you telling me, Mitch?
David, what I'm telling you is that the article you were hired to write was to be about Martha Stewart, not about what you fixed her for dinner.
You know, maybe you should read the piece again instead of skimming it.
Hey, I read the article twice, slowly, okay? You talk about yourself more than a stand-up comic does. It was ridiculous.
You know what? I'm so sick and tired of editors who have to justify their existence. I can go anywhere with this piece. Anywhere.
Really?
Yeah.
Then go! Hey.
Hey, where were you? Epperson was looking for you at the marketing meeting this morning.
Ellen is under the weather. I had to hang around the house for a while.
What, you guys were up all night doing the fertility dance?
No. I better go see exactly what he wants from me.
Mitch.
Hmm.
Don't sweat it, buddy. Epperson's gonna pick you over Hershey. No contest.
I know so. I hope you're right. Come on. Oh, come here.
I told you I don't like that. Say you're sorry.
I'm sorry.
Satisfied? Look what you did.
No. Come on, let it ring.
No.
Let it ring.
I already caught hell from my dad about the customers. You better get out of here.
Thought I was your daddy.
Anybody there?
Can I help you?
Yeah, I need a single.
Telephone here.
This right here and get the rest of the stuff, okay?
care of them. Okay.
I'm glad you're back.
Me too.
You're out of fabric softener.
Oh, Judy, you did the laundry. Why'd you do all this?
Will you just quit nagging me and let me have my moment here? You would do the same for me. I'm just going to run home and get the softener. Ellen?
Yeah?
Listen, if you ever need to talk, anytime.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, we have all new keys for the house, like you know, and also for both cars. Okay, now each car key has a panic button. You push this button down right there. Get that sound, all right? Okay. We also have a device in the cars that can electronically track if it's stolen. Now we've also signed up with Stockade Security. They have cars patrolling the neighborhood 24 hours a day. These are the instructions for the home security system, all right? Now to arm the system, over here. We enter our security code, which just happens to be your birthday.
0417.
Okay. Now, over here.
Mitch, could you stop for a second? What's the matter?
Nothing.
Nothing? You still don't want me to go to work tomorrow, do you?
I just think you're rushing, babe.
I need to go. Even in counseling, they stress getting back into a routine as soon as you're ready. I'm ready. I'm really ready.
Okay, you're ready? You say you're ready? You're ready.
What? Look at me, Mitt. It's this, isn't it? You're embarrassed.
I'm not
yes,
embarrassed.
You are.
No. Look, let's just forget.
Well, I'm not, Mitt. I was raped, and it's not ever going to change, no matter when the bruises go away.
I know that, okay? I know that.
No matter who you tell.
Go to work.
Okay,
whatever,
going,
you know?
Going.
Ellen? Ellen, I'm sorry.
All right, as you all know, I've missed a few weeks of school, and I'm sure you're all wondering what happened to me. Okay, here's the deal. I was assaulted in my home. I had a few injuries, but I'm feeling fine now. I missed you all very, very much, and I enjoyed your essays. And I look forward to torturing you all with impromptu quizzes in the future. So shall we get started?
Are you okay, Mrs. Hayward? Are you feeling sick?
No, Lois. I'm fine. I'm just a little dizzy. Okay, now. Everyone read this chapter?
Yes.
Thank you. Ellen, come on in. I know why you've been having these episodes of nausea. It has nothing to do with the concussion. You're pregnant.
What do you think?
I think that you're starting to get a little bit of that Ellen glow back. What do you think?
That's sweet. It's really sweet, Matt. You're lying, but
I'm
sweet.
Not lying. What's going on with you, huh? How come I'm not eating anything?
Mitch. I need some more water. Do anything?
No. Soon. I thought you were asleep.
It's restless.
This will help me get to sleep.
No, thanks. All right.
Okay. I'll be in pretty soon.
Okay.
Season.
Yeah.
Right over here.
Excuse me, Detective.
Yeah, sit down right here.
Right here.
Mr.
Hayward, Mitch Hayward.
Right. Great. Just sit down.
I was wondering, do you guys have any leads yet? We haven't heard anything.
Well, it's still early. And we're working on it.
Well, what does that mean, you're working on?
Well, it just means we're working on it.
I want to talk to my attorney.
Be quiet.
Look, it's been almost a month. You haven't called. You said you'd call. You haven't called. My wife can't sleep at night.
Hey! Can you hear me, man? I want to call my attorney.
Shut up.
Hey, Bob, you want Cameron's guy for me?
Got him.
Look, we're holding up our end here, huh? You'll hear from us when we have something.
All right, let's go.
No, I want just deal. Let's just
deal. Yeah. Look, we're cross-checking with court records.
And working priors that might fit with this guy's way of doing business and resemble the description in a field kit.
We got a couple of decent possibles. As soon as we know something, we'll give you a call. How's your wife?
She's okay. I don't know where she gets it from, but she's holding up pretty well. It's been tough, you know. Thanks. Yeah, we'll see you.
You've known for a week. What are you planning to do? Wait until it shows? You have to tell him, Al. He loves you.
And I love him. That's the point, Judy.
Look at me. You act like you did something bad. You did nothing wrong.
I know. But neither did Mitch. What about his feelings?
You have to tell him.
I can't bring myself to tell him. I practiced it 1,000 times, and each time it just sounds worse. You know, having a baby meant everything to us. Together.
You have to go talk to Mitch. You guys can work it out.
What if he doesn't want me to keep it?
Well, maybe that's the best thing. Just end the pregnancy.
It's not that simple, Judy. What if this is our baby? What if this is the only baby I ever have?
Hey, computer spit up a possible suspect in the Hayward case. Want to go for a drive?
I didn't lay a hand on her.
Oh, now how's that for talent? He read my mind. Clean. Hey! Leave him alone!
No, step back, lady. We're talking to your boyfriend now, right
here. Oh, now that's a half-assed excuse if I ever heard one. What'd you do, Lewis? Rape her by telepathy?
Rape her in the middle of a shopping mall? What are you talking about? I was there to see my kids. That's it.
You
my kids.
To help
I didn't
somebody
touch
else,
her.
Lady,
I'm telling
huh?
you right
Let's
now.
Get him inside.
Where
Come on,
you
let's go.
Go! Lewis! got some bad credit hanging over your head, Lewis. One count of sexual battery, spousal abuse, stalking. See why we're here now?
No.
No? You drive for Byron Steel Company?
Yes, I do.
Remember delivering some rebar to 923 Lander down in Apple Valley?
Not really.
No? Because it's in the computer. Dispatcher remembers it. You remember it now?
Well, if it's there, then I must have, but I don't remember it.
Hey, Lewis. That hot little number outside, she good to you? You like her?
Yeah, I guess.
Because she sure likes you. Matter of fact, I think she likes you so much she's lying for you. See, she told us you were with her the whole night of February 5th. Remember that night?
No, I do, yeah. Why?
Why? You know damn well why.
Yeah, sweetheart.
Yeah, see, this nice lady here says you were with her. But we think you were somewhere else. Young woman was beaten and raped in her home that night. Lived just kitty corner from where you delivered that rebar just a couple of weeks before. Now, is that just a big, fat coincidence or what? Because we've already got you on one count of sexual battery, Lewis.
As I recall, that case never went to trial.
Mm-hmm, because you had the victim too scared to testify against you. Told her you'd kill her. Same way you told this woman you beat and raped.
I never raped anybody.
Well, prove it to us, Lewis. Give me a blood and hair sample.
I didn't give you anything. If you had anything on me, I'd already be downtown. You had cause, I'd be downtown. She just stole it. I was with her all night.
Oh, can it, Lewis? We know you did it. We know what gives you a rise. We know how you are with the ladies. We are gonna be all over you, like white on rice. And it ain't gonna matter what your little friend here says. Get it?
Can't tell.
It's all right. Just take a few more minutes. Just look carefully, okay?
I just don't know.
Are you sure?
Try. Okay.
It's okay, Miss Savory. We'll keep looking.
Thanks.
You too, huh? Those cops are smart, you know. They know how to frighten people. How to tear people who love each other apart. They know you mean the world to me.
I do.
You know you do. Hey, You think it'd be okay if I used your car for a little while?
Police were here today. They have a suspect. They bought a bunch of pictures.
They have a suspect? Well, that's crazy. Could you pick the guy up?
I can't tell. I don't know.
Okay. You don't know. I mean, you're just trying to be honest. It's phony.
Mitch, there's something else I have to tell you. I'm pregnant. I'm about a month pregnant. Because of the timing, there's no way to tell who the father is right now.
When can you tell?
They have a genetic test that you can take in the fourth month.
Fourth month, huh?
It's not fair.
No, it's not fair. Nobody wanted a baby more than you and me. Now we have one. Or at least we have the chance to have one.
What if it's not our baby?
Then we don't have it. Then we start over. But all we have to do right now is be strong and wait.
How do I do that? How do we wait? I'm crazy.
Like it was our own. It's the only way.
Thanks, Mitch.
Okay, essay is entitled My American Hero or due Monday. 4 pages minimum. More if you're feeling inspired. A girl can dream, can't she? You guys have a great weekend.
See you soon.
Hi. Bye.
Hey, how you surviving this fine Friday?
Well, it could be worse.
It's gonna be. Mm. Yes, Wiley warmed out on me for detention duty. Went home with the flu. Did you take his watch? I've got nobody else.
Yes, I can do that.
Not at all.
I owe you.
Bye.
Bye.
Better to do it that way. I think so. All right. Thanks. Good. I'll see you later. Yeah. Yeah. Thanks.
Hi, we're not here right now, but if you leave your name and number, we'll call you right back. Wait for the beep.
Hi, Al, it's me. It's 3:15. Are you there? Pick up. Hello? Okay, I'll try you later.
Shh. It's detention. You're supposed to be miserable.
What is this?
Nice tattoo, Rafa.
Yeah,
What have we got here?
Get it.
Yeah, Monica, I was raped. You think this is funny? Do you think it's a joke?
No.
Because it's no joke. Okay, Albert, Suzanne, Laura, Monica, you guys can all go.
I'm really sorry, Mrs. Hayward. That was, like, really dumb.
Monica, I know you're sorry.
It was really dumb.
Yeah, it was really dumb. But it's okay. Okay? Well, let's just forget about the whole thing.
Okay.
All right. Can I go now? No, Rafa, you can't. You got a half hour to go. I let you go early last week and you're back.
Can I at least go to the bathroom?
Please do. 5 minutes, Rafa. 5 minutes. Hi, we're not here right now, but if you leave...
Hello, you've reached the administration office of Clay Russell High School. Our office hours are 7:30 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. Please leave a message after the tone and we'll return your call as soon as possible.
I have to leave for the rest of the afternoon, so could you hold my calls and I'll check with you later?
Okay.
Great, thanks a lot.
Mitch!
Yeah?
Just the man I was looking for. We've got to go over this list of writers for the women's issue before you go home today, okay?
Yeah, listen, Reed, I'm kind of out the door. I have a minor emergency at home, so...
I'm out of town tomorrow, so if it's minor, please,
well, it's not really that minor. Can we go over this on the phone?
First thing in the morning.
Fantastic. I really appreciate it.
Do you want your messages, Mr. Epperson?
Hold them.
Rafa. Rafa? Moffett, you better not be playing games with me. Rafa, you can come out now. This isn't funny.
Ah! Oh, man, did I scare you? I'm sorry.
Okay.
I'm really sorry. I saw the door open and...
The door was open?
Yeah, it's always closed. I thought I saw somebody come in. It must have been you.
No, I came in through that way. It must have been Rafa.
Rafa?
Did you see him?
The kid with the crazy hair?
Yeah.
I saw him leave the school a few minutes ago.
Really? Do you think you could walk me to my car? It's just in a lot.
Sure, no problem.
Yes, it's a 1965 Corvair, light blue, Texas plates, 533S... wait a second. Hold on a second. Oh, she's here. Sorry. Thanks very much. Helen?
What are you doing here?
Who are you?
What do you mean? I was at school. I called your office. You didn't get my message.
No, I didn't get your message.
I talked to Cheryl. I had a feeling she...
When did you call?
Just after 3. They needed someone to do detention for
you. Detention?
Why can't you say
God,
no?
I was scared to death. I left work when
you
I...
You were scared?
Yeah.
God was at the school, Mitch.
What? You saw him?
No.
What, someone else saw him?
No, no one saw him. I know he was there.
How do you know that he was there?
I just know.
Well, how?
I heard a noise.
You heard a noise?
Yes.
Ellen, we have an agreement. If either one of us is not...
I called you, Mitch. Your secretary wouldn't put me through. Where's the phone? Hello? It's Detective Cicero. No, everything is not okay over here. The guy was at the school today. He's following me. You've got to get him. You've got to arrest him. He's going to kill me. No, I didn't see him. Well, do more.
Ellen, come on. These guys are on our side. Cut them some slack.
Cut them some slack? Why don't you cut me some slack, Mitch? I'm the one who was attacked, and now the guy's following me, and I want something done about it.
Mr. Dennis, I can't find my time card.
Because you've been laid off.
Laid off? What, for how long?
Indefinitely.
You been fired?
All right, fired.
What for?
You didn't show up for work.
I didn't show up for work one day. I mean, I've been working here almost a year.
Take it.
What is this?
That's severance pay, and it's pretty generous, so why don't you just take it and go?
This is crap. You can't fire me.
Well, I just did. The police have been here asking questions.
So you can't fire me because the police have been here. I'm going to take your court, pal.
Well, go ahead. But I have employees who will say that you're abusive. You fly off the handle.
I don't care what you're...
Nobody even wants to get in the truck with you. Now, you can't work for this company anymore.
I will see your ass in court, pal. This is unbelievable. Just unbelievable.
I was wondering if you could tell me what this is.
Well, where I come from, they call it a present.
Yeah, I can see that. But what's it for?
For hitting one out of the park.
What's that supposed to mean?
I saw the insurance forms on your desk the other morning. Congratulations, Papa.
Oh, you mean the baby?
Baby, yes. Well, sit down. Open it up.
Yeah, sure.
Got any names?
No, not yet. Ah, look at that. Special occasion golf balls. That's great.
Yeah, I thought about getting something for both of you. But Al's going to have the big baby shower with the girlfriend, so...
Right.
I bet you're happy.
I am. We are.
You know, if I were you, I leaked this to Epperson.
He loves kids. Promotion's in the bag then.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Listen, Gil, you haven't told anybody else about the baby, have you?
No, man, I didn't want to steal your thunder.
I appreciate that.
Are you all right, Mitch?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Sure.
Yeah.
Hey, these are great. Thanks.
Gil Jackson gave me a present today. You know why?
Why?
We found out you're pregnant.
Well, he was happy for you. Is that so awful?
Well, yeah, it's awful. You know, I had to basically sit there and pretend, you know, lie to a very good friend of mine. Think if he'd known the truth, he would have given me a present?
Well, maybe if you had told the truth from the beginning.
I don't particularly want the entire world to know. I'm sure you've told Judy.
Of course I told Judy. She's my best friend. And I don't understand why you can't tell your friends.
What the hell am I supposed to say? My wife's having a kid. I don't know who the father is. Come on, give me a break.
Wait a minute. What are we talking about here? Are you saying that you don't want to wait for the test? Is that what you're saying?
I don't want to talk about it right now, okay?
Oh, Mitch.
Ellen, please.
What if it's our baby?
Ellen.
Are you ready to take that chance? Are you...
Ellen, I don't know. Come on. I don't know.
Mitch? Mitch, what are you doing out here?
I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. We're gonna have to quit apologizing. And get through this.
I think we should wait and have the test.
So do I.
I'm going. You still having dinner at Judy's?
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna work late then. But you call me as soon as you get home.
Okay.
All right?
All right.
I'll see you later.
Mitch!
Yep. Yeah.
I love you.
I love you too.
All right, say night.
Going here.
All I can tell you, Mr. Snow, is that as your ex-wife's attorney, I'd advise her to speak to you only in my presence.
Yeah? At how much an hour?
I'm sorry I'm late.
Thanks for showing up.
I wasn't talking to you. Lewis, this had better be good. Get me out of work in the middle of the day. What is it?
Had my severance pay. I got laid off.
Oh.
I had cutbacks. Well, you know, out of my control. Anyway, I just want you to know I'll be keeping up with my payments. And,
That's it?
No.
Oh.
I also wanted to say that I'm sorry about getting in your face with the kids, and I know you provide for them, and you do a good job and a lot of stuff.
Lewis, I don't know what's going on here, but it ain't gonna change anything.
It's not meant to.
Came over here to show you what happens when you don't listen.
Look away. That is my baby. Don't you let anything happen to my baby. Because your life depends on it.
You didn't get a clear look at it.
No.
What did he say?
Well, he was very angry that I'd gone to the police. And he said he'd come here to kill me, but he changed his mind because he didn't want anything to happen to his baby.
His baby?
We found out we're pregnant.
Oh, boy.
Well, why would he think it's his baby?
He found my dating sonogram on the refrigerator door.
Dating sonogram?
They can tell within about 48 hours the date of conception.
Right. The date of conception's very close to the date of the rape.
And you don't know yet who the father is?
No.
He ain't here. You can leave now.
You just got here, darling.
Spare me, okay? What?
When was the last time you saw him?
The day the two of you were here hassling him.
What'd he do, skip in the middle of the night?
No.
Well, why'd he leave then?
Because you two were making his life miserable.
Yeah, well, sweetheart, did he say anything else, like where he was going?
Yeah. He said he was going to go work on the Alaska pipeline.
Listen, honey. We tried to warn you. This guy's bad news. Came back and told the rape victim he'd kill her. See, we think it's your boyfriend, Lewis. We think he's still around.
I haven't seen him, okay? Said he was gonna go down south, look for work in Miami. Said he'd call me when he got settled there.
Well, we paid a visit to the suspect's place, and he's gone.
What the hell do you mean, he's gone?
You knew where he lived? I don't understand why this guy's running around free.
Miss Haywood, we tried to explain that to you at the time. We had no physical evidence. And we had no probable cause to bring him in.
Yeah, well, he's been back again since then. So if you know who he is, pick him up.
You can't identify him, and he's got an alibi.
We're canvassing your area. I'm sure.
No, he's canvassing the area.
We're asking questions, circulating a composite, but we can't...
To what? Nothing certain?
Well, let's go.
Now, there's one thing certain, Mr. Hayward.
This guy's resourceful and he's obsessive.
And he's still out there.
I want you to go to your mom's. I'll give him a month to catch this guy, and then you come home.
I don't want to go.
It's not safe here. You know that.
Come with me.
I'd love to. Ever since making a decision on the editing job real soon, I gotta stick around, but I'll be up every weekend.
Okay.
I promise.
Mitch, be careful. This guy's a maniac. He's been in the house twice. Don't do anything stupid.
What do I look like? Jean-Claude Van Damme?
Yeah.
I don't think so. I'm just a big coward.
No, you're not.
Love them just the same as when you're gone. When they give you that blanket of dirt and make you into snail food, they're all you got left.
Right on. Toast.
Hey, Pete. Right. Give us a couple more here. But guess what? We got another kid on the way. Can you beat that?
Yeah, congratulations.
Let me buy you one.
Sorry, I'm on duty.
We're toasting my kid here. Come on.
Hey.
Drama.
Maybe you don't appreciate children.
Well, then he is a damn fool. Because they're all you got.
Stop! Freeze! Police! Stand up! Hands above your head! Turn around! Cuff it. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law.
It's for you.
Yes?
Hi, Ella. It's Detective Cicero. We finally caught a break.
What is it?
We made an arrest last night. Another rape in your neighborhood. Same M.O. We're going to need you to come in for a lineup. Can you come back this afternoon? Hello, Ellen?
You still there?
Yes. Yeah, I'm here. I'll be there.
sexually assaulted a 28-year-old woman in her house, threatened the woman with murder if she talks. We passed his composite around, and this guy's been spotted in your area more than once.
Rank profile now. I turn to the front, please.
That's him, I think.
Give us a number, Ellen.
Number two. There's something about him.
Okay, you can take him away.
Okay. Rock and roll. Woman who was raped, ID'd the same one.
What about bail? Can this guy get bail?
I seriously doubt it. DA's gonna file a motion to deny. Even if he got it, this guy's not gonna make bail. As far as we checked, he's got no cash, no family. He's going away for a long time.
Good.
That's good news, huh?
Thank God, huh?
Yeah.
This is great.
Epperson's looking for you.
I gotta take Ellen to the doctor. Can you make like I was already gone?
He really looks like he wants to see you now.
Try a different caller right here, okay? Thanks.
I should have gotten to this before, but, well, you know how busy it's been, Mitch, and, hey, this isn't easy, but, I think I've got to go with Hershey. I don't think you're ready for the pressure, Mitch. Don't take this as a consolation prize, but I have put you up for a raise. I don't want to see your name on Esquire or GQ's masthead.
It's getting late.
I'm not going for the test, Mitch.
Okay. I won't just reschedule.
I don't want to reschedule it.
What do you mean?
I think we should wait.
For what, Ellen? We agreed. This is what we wanted.
We wanted to have a baby, Mitch.
We have to go through with this test.
I'm afraid, Mitch. What if I miscarry?
I want this baby just as much as you do.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
I mean, no, you could handle it. You could handle it. You could start over again, but I don't know what it would do to me. And what if it's not our baby? I'm not strong like you are.
No, you're wrong. You've been the strong one. I'm the one who hasn't been there for you. I've been out there running around chasing that stupid promotion. Guess what? Hershey got the job.
I imagine so.
That's okay. But now I see. We can face this together, and starting right now, we will. But do you understand? I have to know. Excuse me, we're looking for Dr. Steinberg.
I'm Dr. Steinberg. Can I help you?
Yes, I'm Ellen Hayward, and this is my husband, Mitch.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Hello.
I'm sorry we're late. Traffic. Less than the jitters, actually.
Mine, not his.
Oh, relax. This is quick and painless. Are you both ready?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Please, follow me.
Thank you.
Donna?
Hi. What are you doing here?
I know I'm not supposed to be here, okay? It's just I wanted to give this to you right away.
Another check. Thought they fired you.
I got another job. So from now on, you know. Yeah, I'll just put it in the mail, but for now, you know. Whatever. Okay. Well, I'll see you later. Say that and kiss for me.
Lewis, wait. Jarrett's birthday party's tomorrow. Ashland Park. Nothing special. Can you make it?
You sure about that?
2 o'clock.
Whatever happens tomorrow, whichever way it goes, I will never love anyone more than I love you.
I love you too.
Hold on 1 second. Hi, Doctor. Steinberg. Are you sure? Okay, thank you, Doctor Steinberg.
I'll see you later, Mr. 4 years old. Happy birthday.
Lewis. Leaving, we didn't even get a chance at talking.
Go ahead.
We're moving.
What are you talking about?
To Tulsa.
You're moving to Tulsa.
We're moving, woman. Please, sweetheart, why don't you go with me, okay? We're moving in with my folks. It's a really good neighborhood for the kids. I've already got a job lined up. Lewis, we're just ready to start a new life.
You can't do that. You can't just up and leave, Donna. What about the boys?
No, oh, yes, I
what?
Can.
What about
talk to the lawyers? Look,
what about
that's
the boys?
Why I invited you here today. I wanted to talk to you about this. I didn't want this to be so abrupt.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did.
Lewis, please.
You can't. You set me up.
Oh.
You set me up.
Don't you touch me, Lewis. You keep your hands on me.
I don't care how long it takes. I do not care. I am going to get my kids back.
Bye, Lewis. Come on, where's Toby? Let's go get Jared.
Every single one of them!
Lewis!
you going? You're never going to make this. The hospital is 20 minutes away. You know this.
We're going to make it. We'll make it. Why don't you not drive like your grandmother?
I'm driving like my grandmother.
Did you turn off the coffee pot?
Yeah. Do you have the alarm?
Got the iron?
Never. Iron?
Put some clothes in the
Would house. You stop? We're not going back in the house, all right?
Come on. Hurry. Hurry.
I have to stop and deliver this baby by myself. I will never forgive you.
What? Why? Haven't you been pregnant?
Yeah, I have.
Oh my God, isn't he gorgeous?
He is.
Congratulations, Mitch.
Thanks.
I'm proud of you both.
Thanks. We made it, didn't we? We really made it.
I'm glad I'm going home.
Wednesday. I thought I'd give her an extra day to be pampered. Plus, it gives me a chance to put together his tricycle.
Tricycle?
Just kidding.
Are you okay?
Yeah, everything's fine. I just needed to hear your voice.
Oh, okay.
What time is it? You should be asleep.
Don't you miss me?
Of course I miss you.
Bed's too big without you.
How's our boy? Is he walking yet?
He's only 2 days old, Mitch.
He's a Hayward. Give him a week. Wait a second. Are you sure you're okay?
Yeah, I'm sure I'm fine.
Okay. I'll see you first thing in the morning, all right?
Okay.
I love you.
I love you too.
Bye.
Didn't stay away. I just thought I'd come down and get him.
Fine. But we would have brought him up to you.
Oh, I was awake. I don't mind. Jake, are you crying? Don't cry. Don't cry.
I still can't
believe it. Beautiful.
Yes, you are.
Can I go for a walk? Are you singing Mama? I didn't want to say anything while we're in there, but you are the most beautiful baby in the nursery. Yes, you are. You're the most beautiful baby. You want to go to Daddy? Wake him up. I think you should. Hey, kiddo. I like your first set of wheels.
If you scream, I will kill you. You'll never see our son again.
don't hurt us.
I don't want to hurt you. I just want my son.
It's not your son. Let me prove it to you. We've had tests. I can show you.
Shut up. I'm not going to have another kid taken away from me.
What are you talking about? This isn't your son. Can't you accept that?
Could you? Could you accept it?
I'll turn around.
You stay
no,
back.
I'm going to take my child.
You are not
going to
take this baby.
Since a man kidnapped a newborn boy from a local hospital, police are looking for this man, identified as Lewis Snow. The parents are Uptake magazine writer Mitchell Hayward and high school teacher Ellen Hayward. They've issued a public plea for the kidnapper to return their child to safety. Hospital officials are imploring Snow to be aware that the newborn requires infant formula every 2 to 3 hours. A warrant has been issued for Snow's arrest. He's described as dangerous, unstable, and probably armed.
Hello?
Something's wrong with the baby.
What? Where are you? What's wrong?
He won't eat. He's crying all the time.
Take him to a hospital, please.
No. You're coming here. You're going to get him to eat. You understand me? Just you.
Tell me where you are.
You listen to me. You bring anybody with you, and I will know. Do you understand?
Tell me where you are.
Parking lot 5th and Trinity.
I was in the shower and the phone rang and she just took off. Yeah, can you find the car with that tracking system thing?
I'll activate it now. You stay put, I'll be right there.
Are you alone?
Yes, where is my...
You better be. Do you want to see your baby?
Yes.
Where is it? Mind leaving him alone?
What was I supposed to do? Take him along? Do whatever you have to do to make him stop crying.
Starve.
Well, then feed him.
go downtown. Let's go.
Okay.
I can't let you have him, you know that. He's all I have.
He's my son. No matter what you think he is to you, he's my son. I'm his mother. You can't take him away. What are you gonna do? How are you gonna feed him?
You just let me worry about that, okay?
You'll wake him. I can manage.
Flex ramp, unit 23.
This is unit 23, go ahead.
Unit 23, subject vehicle license 533 Sam Baker Tom. Located at the corner of 5th and Trinity.
10-4.
That's it, let's go.
For a door-to-door in the vicinity of 5th and Trinity, over.
Hey, I thought you could manage.
Quiet down.
Yeah, well, you better. I got work to do. It here. So don't give me all that weak stuff about what are you going to do.
Anything?
No.
I'm going to hit a fish.
Take me, Allie.
Quiet now.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna be leaving here soon anyway.
Do you wanna hold him?
I could hold him. I held millions of babies in my time. I don't know why I don't hold one more.
Isn't he beautiful?
No. Cicero, over here! Over here! Helen!
Midge!
Stop, you move! Get away from her, you bastard!
Stop!
Stop! Stop! It's over!
Stop!
I'm taking my family.
Don't move!
Look!
Drop the gun, Lewis.
Are you okay, sweetie? You okay?
Yes.
It's all right. It's all right. Is she okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's take our boy home.
You have the right to remain silent. If you give up the right to remain silent, anything you say can and will be used against you.